Okay, let's talk about tunneling beacon over SSH. Here's the scenario. I have a system in red space that can talk to a Linux system in blue space, okay? That Linux system can reach a target I want access to. Now, presumably, I have the information I need to attack that target. Either the information to establish a trust relationship or maybe an exploit if I want to tunnel that through. But for this, we're going to assume we have trust material, okay? So the main idea is I want to be able to attack that target in blue space through this SSH tunnel I create from red space. Let's go through how to do that. To tunnel beacon over SSH, connect to the Unix target in blue space, the blue pivot, and make sure that you enable dynamic port forwarding when you do so. That's the dash D flag followed by a port in SSH. And what the dash D flag does is stands up a SOX proxy server that forwards any connections it receives through the SSH tunnel. Now, on the red pivot system, the system that initiated the SSH connection to the blue system, forward port 445 through the dynamic port forward SOX server we just stood up. SOCAT is really nice for this. Just do SOCAT, listen on port 445, and have the fork option in there so you can take multiple connections. And then just do SOX4:127.001:, put in the target you want to reach on the distant end and port 445, okay? The port 1080 piece is implicit when you do SOX4 this way. There is another option in SOCAT if you need to bind your dynamic port forward to a port other than 1080. If not, this works pretty well. Now, what you've essentially have is a system in red space with listening on port 445, and anything that comes to that 445 is going to reach your target in blue space, okay? Now, to attack that target, just run a beacon on an attacker-controlled host. It's in your best interest to make sure you run it as administrator, okay? So, this is a beacon in red space, but it's going to do your bidding for you. Now, from that attacker-controlled beacon, what you're going to do is load trust material into your access token that Windows will use when it tries to talk to our target system through a port forward, okay? So you can do that a variety of ways. You can use make token to create a token, either for a local account or domain account. And you can even use the pass the hash technique we talked about in the last lecture. Either one is okay. Now, once you've loaded trust material, attack the system. Ideally, with an attack that's going to go over port 445. That might mean creating a service with the sc command. It might mean using psexec or psexec PowerShell. Here's what this looks like in a picture form. You know, we have our red space beacon that is connecting to our port forward. And our port forward is, again, sending that traffic over the SSH tunnel. And the pivot host is directing that traffic to our target. And that's it. That's how you attack a Windows system via beacon through an SSH tunnel. Okay, let's take a look at tunneling beacon over an SSH tunnel. So first, here's my Windows system in red space calling back to my Cobalt Strike team server, okay? I have it calling back interactively, and I want to essentially use this beacon to attack another Windows system with known credentials through an SSH tunnel. So we're gonna do is first, let's note what the IP address of my pivot system is. 192.168.1.2. And let's go ahead and create a dynamic port forward on port 1080. And let's connect to the Linux system that is notionally in blue space. Okay. And what we have on port 80 is essentially a SOX proxy server. And any traffic that goes through this SOX proxy will be fulfilled by the distant end Linux system. Okay. Cool. Now, let's go ahead and hit Control Shift T. And what we're going to need to do is create a SOCAT relay that basically listens on port 445 and sends anything that comes in on port 445 through our SOX server that's running on the same system on port 1080. That's the default. And we want to make it forward to our actual target in blue space, our target that this Linux system can reach. Because if you look, our Linux system here is actually dual homed. Okay. And the target we want to reach is 172.16.20.174, and it can reach it. So let's go ahead and put in the information for it. 172.16.20.174. 445. Okay, cool. Now, anybody that hits us on hits our system 192.168.4, excuse me, 192.168.1.2 on port 445, we'll find that traffic sent through this local SOX proxy server destined on the distant end to reach this host and port, which is ultimately our target, okay? The main thing you need to know is if we attack the team server's IP address, if we attack that, it's the same as attacking the system on the other end of the SSH tunnel. So we've got our beacon going. Let's go ahead and make a token for a user we know is a local administrator on the distant end. We could also do a pass the hash as well, if we had the password hash for that system for an administrator user. And let's verify that those creds work. They do. Cool. Now let's go ahead and just do psexec powershell to deliver a payload without touching disk to 192.168.1.2. And let's deliver an SMB beacon because that will stage over port 445 and it will communicate over port 445. And using psexec, we're attacking the system over port 445. And there we go. We've just gained control of this Windows 10 system by riding through that SSH tunnel, okay? So now we find ourselves in a strange new network tunneled over SSH.